everyone, welcome back to PJ's CAD class. Today we would like to build this Superman ring. It is really popular to have all kind of logo icon onto the Signet ring. So we'll try to build one. I'm going to get the logo from Google and just want to claim it here. It is just for education purpose. It's not meant for the production. So what do we need for this ring? The command you're going to use is quite simple. Let's take a look on that. First of all, we'll go to picture frame. We'll use the picture frame to bring into the image, which is the logo image of this Superman from Google. Once we do that, we will trace the image to get all the curve. Then we can delete that image we searched from the Google. Then we will use the command called sweep to creating the ring surface. After that, we will need to cap the top to make it solid. So then you have a ring that's done. Then after that, you just need to select the Superman logo and using the commands called extrude a planar curve to turn it into the solid. And then you will just use boolean difference to cut out the shape on the top. Then it is done. So let's get started. When we searching for the image, I try to find black and white. That will be easier to track. So something like this one will be great for tracing the image. You probably want to find the line quality is a little bit thinner. Well, at this point, they look similar. So I'm just going to pick a line work. And then I'm trying to save the image and save to somewhere that you can find. All right. So then we will come back to the Rhino. When we come back to the Rhino, we just type it on the command, type it picture frame. And then it will ask you to pick the image, and I will just pick the one I just save. And then you're gonna drag it a window. I usually hold a shift, so they will be like 90 degree. At this point, it doesn't matter how big they are because we just need to get a line work. After we do that, and we can kind of scale to any size we want. Okay, so just want to make sure the line I'm going to use is not black. I'm going to turn it into the red color so it will be easier to see. Before I do that, I also like to lock the picture so it won't like keep clicking on it. Okay, so I'm just going to use a straight line and trying to get as close as possible. Alright, so since this is symmetrical, so I'm going to do is to mirror this curve and make sure your all snap is on. So we want to snap into the endpoint. And then we just need to create a line in between those. Alright, so once I have done everything, I'm going to join everything with this diamond shape. And then next one, instead of tracing over, I'm going to use the offset command. Right now it's 1.3 millimeter, so let me try 2 millimeter. It's still too small, maybe 2.5. It's almost there, 2.7. Okay, and again, in your case, it doesn't... it might be still too small, maybe a little bit. 3. Alright, and in your case, it might be bigger or smaller because we are not working in the exact size. We just want to trace it. So next one, I'm going to use the straight line and do something like that. Okay, so to do the rest of a curve, I like to use the arc tool. The second one is start end point and the point on the arc. So what I do, for example, on this one, I'll make sure my near is on, so it will definitely snapping into the curve, holding my shift, and that will be intersect with the other one, and I'm just move it down like that. So that way I can make sure that That one is symmetrical. All right, so I'm gonna do the same thing right here, snapping into the curve and have something like that. Okay, so the one more here, snapping here and something like that. All right, if they are not perfect, you can always go back and turn on the control point, which is F10, or you can turn on the control point here and kind of try to move it to make it, you know, fit it better. Again, turn on the control point and try to add it like this way. All right, so rest of it, we will need to use the control point curve. And then we're just gonna trace as close as we can. And remember, you can always come back and using the control point to edit. So if that is not like super accurate, don't worry right now. Okay, so once we are done, let's turn on the control point on this one. All right, so I try to avoid any of like kink looking things. So we'll just need to moving those control point until we get a very good result. And try to make it as close as possible. And I also need to do this part, which is the straight line going here. And then again with the arc from here to here, like that. Okay, I think we are pretty good. All right, so let's go ahead and delete the background. So it's easier to see like this. We want to select everything, and then we want to trim the part that we don't need it. Okay, so that will be this part, here, and then here. All right, be careful, I might have extra there. All right, so that's everything. Then once we're done, Y is select, we want to join everything and we want to group it as well. So when we move, it's easier, right? So now let's go to the front view. I'm going to create a ring shank size in like rest of my demonstration is 16 millimeter. Okay, so now this logo is way too big. We want to size down into the size we feel is comfortable. You don't want it like way too big, right? So that's the inside of a ring shank. I think that's a good size. You can make it bigger or smaller, it's really up to you. Okay, so now we have this, we need to actually make sure it's in the right position. So the way we're going to do it, I'm going to use my move tool and want to snap into this end and to the quadrant there. All right, if you look at the perspective, this logo is like right in the middle of there, right? So we want to look at the top view again. This time we want to use the align tool and we want to align to the center, all right? Vertical center. And then I'll just need to type it 0, then it will be there, right? So what's the point is I need to have this point aligned with the middle of my ring shank. So that will look better. It's really up to you where you want to position. I just feel like this look nicer in this way. Okay, so now we have the top is done. We know where it is to the ring. Next, what we need to do is to create the shank. So let's look at the front view. I'm gonna use the arc tool, type it 0, and then roughly about 2 millimeter, I create this like half round shape there, right? The next command I'm gonna use is under the curve tool, you have the extended curve from arc to the center, to the point. So I wanted to do is to create this arc and snapping into the endpoint. Okay, so let me do again. Pick the arc and snapping into the endpoint. All right, so if we take a look on the perspective, you're going to see the shape of our line coming up. Okay, so with this, I want to also creating some sort of a profile in the middle. My goal is to do sweep to rail. And what I mean is this one, this curve, it's going to be split with the point at the bottom. Okay, so you got two curves right now. And this curve is going to sweep to follow this rail and this rail, go all the way to the bottom. Okay, but if we do that, we're gonna have this point all the way to the bottom. Let me show you what this look like. If you have this one and rail one, rail two, cross section, and it's gonna look something like this, right? Really pointed. This is not what we want, right? So I kind of need to give in a control right there, right at the middle there. So I'm gonna use the ellipse tool, gonna snapping into the quadrant here, quadrant there, and then I wanna see like how wide do I need it. I roughly want about this. All right, so I'm just kind of eyeball like how wide I need it. Okay, so we're gonna use exactly the same thing, sweep two, rail one, rail two, it gonna go from U to U, and make sure you select the point on the command bar here and snapping into the quadrant or the endpoint, right? The key for a good sweep surface is you need to make sure you align the arrow nicely, otherwise they will go crazy. Okay, so now we have this really nice smooth surface. And we're just gonna click OK. Let's take a look on the ghost view. All right, so really nice surface. Right here on the top is still empty. We need to make it into the solid. So I'm gonna use the command called cap, C-A-P. And then now it is solid, okay? The next things to do is, this is our ring size. I'm going to extrude a planar curve straight and make sure it is solid, right? So now we are having those two shapes, going to use the bowling difference, cut it out the inside of a ring shank. All right, so now we have this. Rest of it, we just need to cut out the pattern on the top. So I'm gonna pick up all the closed curve here, here, and here, all of them, and use the same command under the solid. You have extruded planar curve straight, okay? I don't wanna go way too deep, probably just 1 millimeter. So you type it one, enter. It will go 1 millimeter up, 1 millimeter down. Okay, the reason I do both sides is because I wanna make sure they are intersect, right? So we use the bowling difference. You're gonna pick up this one and then use those other cutting tool to cut it off, right? For the bowling difference, the trick I will remember, always pick up the one you want to keep, and the second one will be the one you want using as a cutting tool, right? So now we have this. If you just send this for render, it doesn't look good because you see all the sharp edges. So every time I do model, I try to do the fillet the edges if possible, or you want to do bevel edges. Okay, so on the radius for the ring shank, let's try 0.3 millimeter and see how does that look. It look all right. All right, so we're gonna do 0.3 on the other side as well. 0.3333. Okay. All right, and then on the top, I don't want it to look round. I do want it to look like a little bit bevel edges. So I'm going to use the chamfer. And let's try 0.5 and see how big it is. You definitely don't want it to be too big and cut into the pattern. All right, this look good. Let's take a look on the render view. Okay, that's look good. All right, this is what I have you for you today is a Superman signet ring. Please like and comment on my video and share my video. That helped me on the ranking at YouTube and also able to make a more free video for you. All right, I will see you next time. Thank you for watching.